microphone is special. You have to hold it like a singer. And it's just
sing.
Mountain, you gotta keep it close. Just like that.
Wow.
There you go.
You are a good singer.
Pretty good.
Must be talking to him. All right. Here with Chris and Glenn Gronkowski, Gronkowski brothers, are here with us at, with Your Rules. Step in a little closer to the camera. Make sure we get that. That's good. That was hard to keep me in the frame, so I appreciate you guys.
What kind of a beast? You sure I'm in it?
We good?
Yeah, we're good.
All right, appreciate it. Hey, you guys obviously grew up. You all played sports. You all played football. And then was there any? And you're not even hunters. It's really incredible that you guys are a football family.
I actually got asked today if I was Gronkowski from the Patriots.
No way.
So I guess I'm a kicker now.
Oh, there you go.
Sweet job.
Was there anybody in the family that like wanted to break out of it? Wanted to be like an accountant? Anything like
that? Hey man, I have an accounting degree.
Well, there you go.
Thank you very much.
Was that a secret thing that you wanted to do your whole life, but then you were forced into playing football?
No, I went to college and I got the degree, and then I was like, this sucks.
That's how I felt taking accounting too. Finance also. Those were brutal classes.
Well, we're best friends now.
It is, man. That's good. So nobody wanted to break out for Halloween? Did anybody like go as a banker or something like that? Or
I was actually Chicks McGavin. Last time I dressed up.
Last time I put baby chicks on me and magnets, so I was a chick magnet for last Halloween. Thank you.
That's it. Hey.
So yeah, I broke out. I wanted to be a chick magnet, but never worked out.
Didn't work out. That's a shame. But yeah, I mean, seriously, you guys living the dream, man. It's been great having a family that grew up together. I mean, being tight. How important? I mean, obviously, family is important. How important is that? Versus, you know, just the life of living football.
I mean, it's huge, especially coming in as a rookie. Just motivation, really. I mean, you have three other brothers who play in the NFL, and are you going to be the fourth one that doesn't? I think that's the best motivation in the world, right? So you got to be a beast. You got to go out there. And that's your straight motivation, and all came from just growing up competing with each other. You got five boys in one house every day. The friends over. You're just going at it. A brawl, no matter what. If you won or you lost, you're just going to get in a fight anyways because you were pissed off because you either won and they're mad or you lost and you're mad. So all out brawls every single day. I don't know how my parents handled it.
Didn't you guys have your own room to like settle all the scores?
Yeah,
we
had a basement. That's exactly what it was. We had to put up boards to check each other's room, and just got insane. All the insulation on the walls was ripped off. It was just concrete walls. We had to put up wood boards, and does that even help? I don't know.
No, split my chin open.
Glenn split his chin open Christmas Eve.
Yep.
So we can go.
They were throwing me through
Christmas
the boards.
Day. That's what Christmas is.
Did you guys ever want to play like? Did you guys ever play like hockey down there or something?
Yeah,
that's exactly what you guys did.
We played mini sticks.
It's a mini stick arena. That we're
little boards up. Fake hockey sticks, and we go out there and play mini sticks, and then get in the play.
That's awesome. What about playing other sports in high school, things like that? Or was it just always going to be football for you guys?
No, we played everything. Basketball, hockey. Hockey was big up north where we're from.
Sure.
Basketball, hockey, football, and baseball. And our other brother actually played baseball in MLB, so he went the baseball route. But yeah, we played everything growing up. We actually didn't start football until eighth grade, so. That's actually our last sport to try out. We played everything else growing up, and then once we got to high school, we played football, and we all just took over from
there. What about soccer? Are you guys going to get into soccer at all?
We never got into soccer.
Nobody gets into soccer. This is America. Nobody plays. That's amazing, but you guys are amazing athletes all the way through. I love the fact that, as a younger brother, you have to, I mean, you see everybody doing it all along. Did it make it easier to see the older brothers successful at it? And just that was like the expectation, well, I'm gonna be successful too.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's actually older, so.
Yep.
But yeah, once you saw that one person you could do it, you say, oh, I saw how they did it. I want to be like them. You want to go out there and do what they did. So, you know, they didn't get there just by doing nothing. They went out there. You saw firsthand all the hard work they put in, so when it's your turn, you go, hey, that's how you do it. I know what to do. I know what I have to do to get it there. So definitely helped out a lot having someone to look up to like that.
Yeah, it's like even like stuff like learning to swim as a family. You see all your other brothers swimming. You're like, I don't need these floaties. Get these out of here. Did you give up the floaties when you were eight or younger than that, maybe?
Just kidding. I don't know. We used to just go in there, go in and ball and see what happens.
That's awesome. So what are you guys up to? What are you guys up to now? What's been going on?
You promote this one.
Yeah, absolutely. Love to hear it.
Time for some promotions.
That's right.
Also, after ball, just continue to live a healthy lifestyle. Actually, my wife started a business, worked with that for a while, and then about a year and a half ago, started our own company called The Ice Shaker. So we were on Shark Tank in October, got a deal from Mark Cuban, Alex Rodriguez. It's just blown up since then. We actually have a booth over there today.
Wow.
So it's just a better cup, insulated shaker bottle. It's not going to absorb odor like a plastic shaker bottle does. Kind of just an overall cup for anyone who's living an active lifestyle, trying to get your water in. Get some supplements in, mix it up, and use it at the office everywhere. So I'm just taking off since then and just putting the work in on that.
How much was there more pressure going to football or presenting something for Shark Tank? That stuff is intense.
Man, football, for sure.
All right.
I mean, you don't sleep when you're playing. It's a million eyes on you every single practice, every single day. And you know the second you made one mistake, you're going to be up all night thinking about it. And you're going to hear all about it the whole next day, probably the whole next week. And it was hard. I don't think I slept for three seasons that I played.
Wow. That's amazing. Yeah, it does. You internalize every loss, everything that comes around. Definitely internalize it. What could I do better? That kind of thing. Because you never get that moment back.
Never. There's a lot of stress. People say, oh, it must be so fun playing a game. And, it's not. It's a job. It's a job at that point. You get paid for it. Expectations are extremely high. And then you got people like this playing fantasy football. They really let you know about it.
Yeah.
But fantasy football and the sports betting and everything. I mean, there's so many people that just love the game, love watching. And even when you're blowing a team out, they still want to see more points. So that's what it's all about. And all that pressure comes down onto the players. So better perform.
If anybody has any questions, they can step up. Anybody from even from the Urals team here can step up and ask a question. They are so bashful. It's amazing. There we go.
All right, I got to ask you this question because I know your brother's into the WWE and supporting Mojo Riley. Is Riley ever going to be a champion in the WWE, or is old brother going to ever compete in the WWE, even at WrestleMania or what have you?
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah, he won what, the Royal Rumble?
Royal Rumble at WrestleMania.
You're talking about the national champ though, like the heavyweight champion of the world?
You gotta say it in character.
I might give him maybe the Intercontinental Championship. Maybe in like 5 years. But that's for Mojo. Rob, he might get lucky if he wins one match. So, I mean, he just comes in and...
He's ready to go.
Yeah, he just knocks some people out and gets out of the ring, but that's not an official win. He can't last for the whole round. So that's how I see it happening. He might come in, we'll help Mojo out, and that's about it, just like last time.
All right, any other questions? Now we're going to thank Glenn Chris for their time. Again, see them here. With the staff, one more plug, Ola.
Ice Shaker booth.
Oh, for me?
Yeah, one more plug.
IceShaker.com. The best bottle in the world.
One more time.
You don't get one, you're a chump.
All right, I'll take 10. Send them over.
We got an order of 10 already.
Wow.
IceShaker.com. Give me now.
All right, thanks, fellas. We want to thank the Gronkowski brothers for coming out here. Appreciate the time and good luck to you and what you do. We'll see you down the road.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Appreciate it. Yeah, you bet. Well,